On this week's show, Faraday Future commits to building a $1 billion electric car factory in Nevada, Volkswagen comes clean about Dieselgate, and the Nissan LEAF turns 5. These stories and more coming up next on 10. Enjoying today's show on YouTube and want to read the stories we're referring to today? Just head to our website at transportevolve.com/TEN, where you'll find today's show notes, as well as links to the latest future car news, buying guides, tech primers, and car reviews. It's Friday, December 11th, 2015. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and here's what's been going on this week, starting with a little celebration in honour of the Nissan LEAF's 5th birthday. As we explained on Thursday, it's been 5 years this week since the 5-seat Japanese electric hatchback went on sale around the world. Since then, we've seen nearly 200,000 LEAFs roll off the production line, collaboratively travelling more than 1.6 billion zero-emission miles in the process. And while most of the LEAFs on the roads today are still using their original battery pack, Nissan also announced this week a new partnership with power management specialists T.E.N to build and sell static energy storage products built with used Nissan LEAF battery packs. You see, when the pack has reached the end of its useful life in an electric car, it's still perfectly fine for use in a lower current energy storage application, meaning that one day those 200,000 LEAFs will help kickstart another energy revolution, one in which we store our renewable energy from our homes rather than burn dirty coal and fossil fuels. It's pretty neat. Moving on from birthday celebrations to celebrations of another form, it's time to head to Las Vegas, Nevada, where enigmatic electric automaker Faraday Future has announced its intent to build a $1 billion electric car manufacturing facility just 20 miles from the famous Strip. Normally, at this point, we'd be showing you some exciting B-roll footage of the factory or perhaps the car, or maybe even the announcement. But since Faraday Future, or FF as it likes to be known, is keeping a tight radio silence until CES next month, we've got these few teaser images to share with you now. What we can tell you, however, is that the Faraday Future facility will bring an estimated $85 billion in revenue to the area, as well as make Nevada home to the second high-end automaker, the first, of course, being Tesla Motors and its massive Gigafactory facility just outside Reno. We're heading to CES ourselves next month, so hopefully we'll be able to bring you first-hand pictures of what this mysterious new car actually looks like, so stay tuned. Next up, here's a story that caused a fair bit of controversy this week among electric car fans, especially Tesla Model S owners. You see, our friends over at Green Car Reports ran a story midweek which suggested that as many as two-thirds of all Tesla Model S electric cars made between 2012 and 2013 would suffer a drivetrain failure after driving just 60,000 miles or more. Using data downloaded from a recent Plug-in America survey, the site carried out a viable analysis on 370 Tesla Model S cars, noticing that the number of cars with recorded drivetrain placements and then extrapolating it forwards to make some predictions for the future. Why the high rate? Well, those early Tesla Model S cars did have a drivetrain flaw in their design, something that Tesla says it's now fixed and shouldn't be a problem for newer model year cars. If you do happen to own a Tesla Model S and it's an early one, we'd love to know how reliable your car is proving in the comments below. We're off to Switzerland and Germany with this next story, which covers the latest goings on in the world of the FIA Formula E Championship. As we told you on Tuesday, the mountain nation of Switzerland announced the end of a 50-year motor racing ban this week by giving Formula E official approval to race there in the 2016-2017 Formula E race series. The nation, which enacted the ban on motorsports following a terrifying and tragic crash at the 1955 Le Mans 24-hour endurance race, will spend the next year preparing the roads in the alpine city of Lugano, making sure that it doesn't suffer the same fate as the track in London at last year's Formula E finals. Meanwhile, the city of Berlin itself may be saying goodbye to Formula E, at least temporarily, for the 2015-2016 season. That's because the Tempelhof airfield in Berlin, where the race was held last year, is currently home to several hundred refugees fleeing conflict in the Western Asian country of Syria. But it's not all bad news. A new track has already been located in the form of the Nürburgring in Nuremberg, which Formula E CEO Alejandro Agag said should be perfect for some proper racing. I can't wait. Staying in Germany, Volkswagen's luxury performance brand Porsche confirmed this week that it intends to bring the Porsche Mission E all-electric sports sedan to market before the end of the decade, the latest automaker to announce its attempts to catch Tesla Motors in the high-end segment. And as we explained on Monday, the Porsche Mission E was originally unveiled earlier this autumn as a concept car at the Frankfurt Motor Show. But positive feedback and presumably ever-tightening emissions requirements means that we'll see it enter production as something of a halo car for the luxury mark. Porsche says its decision to bring the Mission E to market will come alongside a massive investment in the brand that will result in expansion of its existing engine plant in order to manufacture the electric motors it needs to power the luxury car. On paper, the car is fast enough, but given the rate at which Tesla Motors innovates, we think the Mission E may find itself outperformed and outpriced when it finally launches in 5 years' time. Of course, keeping up with Tesla isn't the only challenge facing the Volkswagen Group right now. Indeed, this week, the automaker came clean about the reasons why it ended up purposely cheating on those emission tests. You know, the ones which led to the whole Dieselgate scandal thing, which has been going on for nearly half a year now. In an official statement made on Thursday this week, Volkswagen chairman Hans-Dieter Porsche said that while Volkswagen believes a reasonably small number of engineers are believed to have been party to the deceit, the emissions cheat came about, they claim, because the US emissions requirements for nitrogen oxides were just simply too tough to meet. At least, they were too tough to meet given the time frame that was given to them by Volkswagen's bosses. Which, I've got to admit, is a kind of lame excuse to make, especially when you're in already that much trouble. But hey, there is at least a bit of sunny sky out there for Volkswagen. This week, CES confirmed that it would be giving a keynote at next month's show, as well as unveiling an all-electric concept car, which rumors suggest could be a near-production ready version of an all-electric Volkswagen camper van. I hope they're right. Volkswagen might be making an appearance at the 2016 Consumer Electronics Show, but so too will Ford Motor Company, which announced on Thursday that it's about to invest a massive $4.5 billion in expanding its research and development into electric vehicles, as well as developing a new range of electrified cars before the end of the decade. At the top of the list, giving a much-needed range boost to the Ford Focus EV. That boost in range, which Ford says will give the electric hatchback a 100-mile range and quick charge capability for the first time in its life, will be the first of 13 new electrified vehicles to join the Ford family. Indeed, by 2020, it says, more than 40% of its global nameplates will be available with some form of electrification or other. Although I'd not be doing my job if I didn't point out here that electrification doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be a plug-in car. But it is great news, and given the new 2017 Ford Focus EV will most likely be on display in Las Vegas, I'm hoping to get some time there with it while I'm there. And finally, as anyone who's been keeping close tabs on Tesla Motors will tell you, the Californian automaker and energy product manufacturer is currently undergoing massive expansion as it attempts to bring out not one but four different products to market in the near future. From developing its autopilot software through to the Tesla Model 3, the Gigafactory, and its Tesla Energy products, Tesla is now in the midst of the biggest recruitment drive of its history, and it's advertising more than 1,656 situations vacant on its website. Tesla is looking to hire everything from software and hardware engineers through to manufacturing, sales, and yes, even detailers. And what's more, the jobs themselves are quite literally spread around the world, with even a few night shift service team positions up for grabs too. So, if you're in the market for a new job and Tesla sounds like the next place for you, you may want to brush up on that resume. Well, that's all we can fit in today, despite trying really hard to squeeze some more stories in. As usual, you'll find all the news that's fit to print at our website at transportevolve.com, catch up with us on Twitter at transportevolve, or check out our latest shows on our usual YouTube channel. And if you liked what you saw today, please consider keeping us independent and impartial by visiting our Patreon page at patreon.com/transportevolved and pledging your support from as little as $1 per month. If everyone who watched this video made that pledge, it would not only fund some great new shows, but allow us to expand our staff too. So go on, help us out. As always, there's a lot we haven't managed to fit into today's show, including how Aston Martin is getting ready to pick a location for its new electric car production facility, Hyundai previews the Ioniq, a car that will be only available with a plug-in hybrid EV or regular hybrid drivetrain, we review a lowering kit for the BMW i3, and we share five silly things that you can still do at the gas station even if you don't own a petrol-powered car. So when we're done, be sure to head to our site to read them all. Thanks for watching. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Have a great weekend, and until next time, keep evolving.